Okay. As you can see here, there is much, isn't much Lightning Talks planned. Yeah? Is this better? Yeah. Okay. There is not much planned on Lightning Talks currently. There are two Lightning Talks. One from the Flying Circus and one I can't exactly remember. Over the what it means to be Orga. What? Sorry? Okay, I didn't check that one yet. Okay, that's three Lightning Talks. You want a Lightning Talk too? I'll walk to you. So that's four. That will probably work. Okay, good. I am going to give the stage to Sebastius for the awaited ethics and governance discussion.
Hopefully going to work.
It works. All right. No, I'm not able to use a microphone because I need my hands for this. Sorry. I'll talk loud because I'm used to talking in the classroom. It's basically the same volume. If you can't hear me, just get a bit closer. There's plenty of room inside. That's about what I can do. I'll try and stand in the middle a bit, but then he'll kill me. So we'll have to make this work. Well, shit, here I am. Did I just curse on live web stream?
Yeah.
Okay.
YouTube's gonna kick us.
Is the audio actually picked up? Or
if you don't use a mic. Yeah, there's a microphone over there. So we're being bugged at the moment. Yeah, that's a nice opening for this discussion. I'm Sebastian, also known as Sebastius. That's quite easy to remember, or you can just call me Abbas or Sebastian, whatever you prefer. I'm not really used to talking in English, but I'll give it a go. I'm a teacher by day and a bit of a hacker. My first lesson this year was called Cyber. I taught and I introduced my students to the world of cybercrime and differentiated between the criminals and the hackers. So I tried to combine both. Responsible disclosure. I am a previous government employee. Just so you know, I used to work in a primary education, which was state funded, so I used to be part of the government.
I elected the government.
Sorry?
I was part of a government election. Partly responsible for.
Yeah. Well, and that's what we're going to talk about today. There's been a lot of discussion on the mailing list, mainly on IRC. And also in real life, about how we should, let me try and phrase this correctly, how we should embrace or not embrace people from the government in our organization. That mainly, and secondly, regarding content, regarding finance, regarding, well, nearly everything that hits our organization, which we need. And, well, that's to be expected because we have had a lot of contact with the government in both negative and positive ways. The joke 6,000 hackers arrested, it's real, it happens. So we need to get serious about this. We need to have a proper sit down about this and we'll figure out what we want. And a few of you have an opinion, a few of you have a strong opinion. Some of you may not already have formed your own opinion, and that's what we're going to do today. Okay, let's see. Just a check, quick check. Did everyone except projectleiding get a tracking cookie? Is there anyone left without a tracking cookie?
I don't have one.
Oh dear, and you were even in the car with me. Oh, did I just disclose information?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I'm not good at this. Yeah. But, here you go. The tracking cookie, sir? I've not seen the number. It's all done. I'll just pass the bag around and just get room from the top, because else the system will fail. I've not seen the numbers. There's no list of it. It was made in Microsoft Office. I'm sorry. So possible data leaks. Also, this is a Windows machine. I'm sorry. I'm a crappy hacker at that. All right. For the first, this discussion is going to take place in three rounds. No, you're project lighting, so you're not entitled to.
Yes, but I also. Is the system proof against people with multiple copies?
Is the system proof against people with multiple copies? Well, since you can't split yourself in two, it should work. You can try and bypass the system. You can trade the cookies around now if you want. I really don't mind. Yeah, just to randomize it a bit. I just chose this with a fair die roll, so you might want to randomize again. Okay, this is going to take place in three stages. The first one is leveling. It's just getting to know each other, warming up a bit to prepare for the discussion. Second stage is leveling the playing field. What do we know? What are the opportunities? What are the risks? And the third stage is setting our rules and guidelines. What are our ethics? What are we going to do, and what are we going to adhere by? A bit of caution. The discussions never end in one specific course. You might not get your point of view into everyone's head. And you have to decide for yourself if that's okay with you, if you're able to still work in SHA Orga or not after this discussion. That's up to you. It's a bit of a warning. That's something I cannot do, is program everyone with the same thoughts. That's why we're here, basically. Okay, well, let's get going. I normally do this form by having the people walk around in the classroom. This classroom is a bit small, so we'll just take a stand. Please close your laptops, put your phones away, you don't need them. Be careful where you put them, because we're going to stand up and sit down and move around. So please put your electronics away. You don't need them. We just want this part of the world, not the outside world. And I'm asking something very difficult. I have this discussion with my students every day regarding their mobile phone.
It's the YouTube stream. Close your laptop.
Close your laptops, please. Bye. Oh dear. Okay. You can, but that's because you're project leading, so that's okay. All right. Well, these are simple questions. I'll either give you two choices or just a yes/no. If yes, stand up. If no, sit down. And it's you have to decide. There's no discussion, no gray areas, no maybe if, when, this, then. No, just yes, just no, black and white, choose. And choose quickly. Okay, first question. Star Trek or Star Wars? If you're Star Trek, stand up, or Star Wars, sit down. All right. Thank you very much. Sit down, please. All right. That gets the spirit going. All right. Second one.
Please realize that the lower half of the screen is very hard to see in the back.
Okay.
So you have a lot of white space on the top?
Yeah. I'll zoom in even, maybe. It's a Microsoft product. What do you expect?
It's not
the most efficient, but it works in the classroom, so that's why I bought it. All right. Second question. System D. Yes, stand, or sit, no. And if you just question what is System D, then it's up to you. All right, thank you very much. Have a seat. Okay. Next one. I am currently, or just have been recently, a government employee.
Define recently.
Define recently in the past year, whatever.
Define government employee.
Oh, come on.
Professors?
You can interpret it for yourself. If you have been part of some form of government or government funded or anything.
Universities.
How about social benefits?
I did not see that coming.
Mortgage deductions. Do they count or not?
Oh dear. All right, have a seat.
No, but seriously, I mean, you're a teacher and you were, in that sense, a government employee.
Yeah.
Do you include that?
Yeah, I include that. All right. Are you in a team at the moment? If you are, if you are in a team at the moment, stand up, please.
There are multiple teams.
Could be cool. Wow. Well done, everybody. Please have a seat. That's amazing. That's what I'd like to see. All right, this one was sent in. It's a long one, so I'll also tell you. This event celebrates hacking, technological freedom, and freedom through new appliances and technology. You are welcome to join, as long as you are a hacker or want to be one. If you agree, stand up. If you don't agree, have a seat. And there's no discussion about the wording or whatever. There may have been a spelling error or a grammatical error. This is what you have to do with it. All right, have a seat. Thank you. Okay. Oh dear. I think it's crapping out. Yeah. That happens regularly in classrooms. Sorry.
Seriously?
Yeah.
So why are you still using it?
Because it's the best. It's the best way to actually work for me. This works a lot better when you're writing stuff down than going like this with 16 or 17 year olds.
Okay.
Uh-huh. You have to look them in the eye. All right.
What are you comparing us to?
Yes.
No, not more than that. But interpret it as you like. All right. The reasons for the Justice Department to try and stop this event are gone. If you agree, yes, stand up. If you don't, sit down. The reasons for the Justice Department to try and stop this event are gone for a while now. Sorry, I forgot the last part. If you agree, stand up. If you don't, sit down.
About the entire set of reasons? Specific subset?
No, it's specifically made broad.
Specifically made ambiguous.
Yeah. Right. All right. Thank you. Have a seat. It seems for half of us, we've lost our edge. Just saying. But it's nice to see that some progress has been made in accepting us as a culture instead of just a bunch of criminals. All right. That took a lot of energy. All right, let's go. It's time to start leveling the playing field. I'm new to the hacker scene. I don't know everything. I've been on the IRC and I've just been, pretty vocal about my opinion. Sorry about that. Well, not really sorry, but this is the point where I step a bit away because I've learned a lot the past few days about what happened in the past. I was not aware of that, and I thank you for the few people who took the effort to write, and also the people I talked to in person. So that's pretty awesome, but there are probably a lot more like me who don't know everything. So it's also quite impossible to know everything, but this is where the tracking cookie comes in. The tracking cookie is a randomly assigned number I gave you at the start. I have no list of it, I have no record of it. It keeps you anonymous-ish. That's up to you. If you want, you can swap it around with your neighbor right now. But during the session, please keep the same number, because that else it'll really bug the system. But that's, even that, you can try and exploit it. Ben ik nog steeds te verstaan achterin?
Ja.
Mooi. Cool. All right.
Question.
The way we're going to discuss this is a form. And sorry, I just stole a picture from the Googles. Oh, I used Google. I'm a lousy hacker. It's called the placemat. The placemat. And the structure is, you do this in three rounds. The first round is that you start in your own area, gather your own thoughts, write your points down, and just keep it to yourself. Second round is you have this little discussion with your group. Each one makes his points, states his case. And if you agree, you write it down in the center. If it's something you have all thought of, if you all agree on that, write it down in the center. You can change it together. That's up to you. So what happens then? Then during that talk, people from project leiding will walk around and note all those center ideas, all those ideas from the majority of their group. And that is something we're going to point out later. We're going to compare notes between the groups back here. We're going to compare notes and then see, okay, this and this and this matters to us, and this is just one person or one group. It might be irrelevant, but not really paramount for our survival. All right? Okay. Question?
However, are you supposed to just write down terms, or is it like actually ideas?
The trick is just you don't have time for writing a book. Just short sentences, keywords, points of interest.
So questions or statements?
For this one, mainly you'll probably have mainly statements. But then again, it's up to the group. Concerns might be formulated as questions, so that's up to you. So at the end of this round, we gather back here, we put them all up on the wall, and we compare notes, and after that we go into round two. Similar structure, different set of questions. Point that out to you later. Okay.
Project leiding writes down the center things, right? The
yeah.
The one that everybody
yeah.
agrees on.
Yeah.
How much time per round?
I'll explain to you in a minute.
Okay.
First a question. What are the risks and opportunities? Please try and find both. What are the risks and opportunities allowing government and employed people into our organization? And I'm not meaning volunteers at the event itself, this organization. What are the risks and opportunities of doing that? That's the question I would like you to discuss. It doesn't cover everything that has been on the mailing list, but it's a good starter to get ourselves going. Use your collective history, use your collective knowledge, experience maybe, to get that together. We have. I'll show the. We'll handle that later. In a minute.
Yep.
Just a second. Okay. So on your tracking cookie, there's a number and a letter. The number is the one we're going to use right now. So when we get going, grab your get your number, gather the people from with the same number. So the numbers one go together to up until nine. The nine group is a bit small because of a lot less people here than expected. But we'll figure that out as we go along. Gather your group. As a group, grab a placemat. Grab a placemat, grab some pens or markers or whatever you feel comfortable with. There's plenty. Don't hoard them, please. There's not 100 pens here. Gather your group, get some idea, get your own ideas going in. We'll set a timer for about 2, maybe 3 minutes to gather your own thoughts. Then have a discussion of about 5 or 6 minutes. So we should be back here in 15 at the most. It's just a quick run through, not a lengthy discussion, not going through all the details. Please just this topic and a bit of history. Do not set the rules yet, just the concerns and the opportunities. Your question, please.
Yeah, I don't have a strong opinion on the whole ethics and government point of view, and I'm at least not by my standards for having a strong opinion. And I don't really want to be a stick in the mud here, but I'm not quite comfortable with someone guiding the debate by setting by phrasing the questions we are going to discuss in a specific way. From a representative point of view, if you set the questions we are going to discuss, you set easily half the outcome. This works.
Yeah. This one I've also had, not from you probably, but from someone on IRC. This was, I volunteered basically for handling this discussion to project leiding, talk to McFly, talk to Stitch. That's scrapping out again, whatever. I may not be the most qualified person. This is what we have to deal with. If you're up for it, I welcome your input. This is what we got. And we'll see if this works. And if it doesn't, we'll think of something else.
I'm not sure we will see if it works.
Sorry?
Can we come up with other questions that we consider important?
If it pertains to this discussion, then you can use, sure, why not? It's also a bit organic. It depends on the group you end up with the people, the points they make.
I would like to add something there. So I haven't seen the format till now at all. I had completely not included in the building of this thing. I would like to use this to see if it actually works, because we have tried a lot of different ways of discussing this topic, and all of them so far has proven to not work. So given the results that we had so far, I would at least try this. And what I would, from my point of view, have is a discussion after that. In total, I don't know if that's even included in the program. If that is an acceptable outcome for enough people, because this might result in some people saying, okay, I know this result, I don't want to, or I can't be involved. And we would have to possibly also see what those consequences are, because group dynamic things can go horribly awesome and horribly bad. So we'll just guess, try to find out, have a result hopefully, and then discuss over the result, because this might actually have consequences for some of the people, and we will have to see if that's acceptable for everybody or not.
Is that satisfactory for your question?
Good
enough for the moment. Okay. Then I suggest we just get started. And like McFly said, this is not the perfect form. This is not the final form. Oh, that sounds Dragon Ball Z. sorry. But this is something I'd like to try. I've had experience in running this, so this is the format I know. And the best suggestion I had to at least get going, because the discussion on the mailing lists and on IRC are taking way too much time for way too many people, and are not getting results. So,
can I have a question? If this is such a sensitive topic, and it already exploded the mail list, and it already exploded at home, and there is a lot of debate about it, why do we just get 1 hour, and it's already like 3:40? So in total, we have half
I've been
hour.
I've been talking way too long. Well,
so
we'll see how we can.
It's impossible now.
No, we'll just see, and we'll fix that as we go along.
The answer for that is pretty easy. The discussion is an important discussion from what I've seen, roughly 40-50% of the Shah Auger. There's a lot of people who are today who are explicitly not here because we are wasting time with this discussion again. That is something I don't like, because I think the discussion should be more public and everybody involved should be involved in the discussion. But it also has to be said that we are already at a point that several people said, I will not be here because we are just discussing about this shit again anymore. It's just that people don't want to put fuel and that is a quote. And I actually had discussions with not one or two or three people about that. When I tried to see if the people that I saw on the wiki that are missing and not coming over here, but they're involved in the organization, when I just saw that, like, there is people that are very happy and very active that haven't signed up for that.
Right.
And
I'd like to interrupt at this point. I think you are already taking way too long. You're repeating yourself.
I think we
can
also add
please,
more time
to
that.
Let's just get going and waste
yes.
less time.
Okay.
Exactly. No matter.
So, for now, in less than 10, in less than 15 minutes, you're back with your sheet and your group. Get going.
Get a sheet here. So
get a group,
six.
Get a sheet. All right, everyone. everyone. Let's get going again. Okay. All right.
Please also try to come inside. There is 7-8 seats over here that are free, and it would be nice to have not to yell too much to everybody. So for all of those who are standing at the outer borders of this universe, please come in here.
Okay. Wow. First of all, a big thank you to all of you, especially to the ones who were skeptical about the format or my questions or whatever. Great work. We did a lot in, well, about 15 minutes, maybe a little bit more. Maybe I cheated a bit. That's teacher's prerogative. When the discussion is very active, you just give people a little bit more time to get sorted out. What hangs here on the wall is our collective knowledge, our collective experience, our collective ideas, morals, etc. This is us. Yeah. And, well, at least a bit of it. At least part of it. Agreed?
Yeah.
And, okay. So, a lot of knowledge was shared. And the fun part is, in yourself now, you carry about the knowledge and the viewpoints of about 4 or 5 people, depending on the size of your group. So your own point of view might have shifted a little bit, which is nice. Next part of the discussion is the same format, only this time we follow the letter instead of the number on your card. Just a second, please. You don't need to take it just yet. I asked Project Leiding to have a look around and note our similarities. What do groups agree on? What are the trends in our discussion? What are we worried about? What are the opportunities we see as a whole group? So, McFly, can you point out one or two points? This is not going to cover everything. It's just going to take 1, maybe 2 minutes, just a few highlights you've seen, something you've noticed.
First of all, I noticed that the even though the groups were randomly put together, the opinions between the groups, from what I see, actually differ quite a lot. And I think that quite a lot of groups also raised a question, which in my opinion is maybe actually a conclusion on their. And that would be, do we maybe have the wrong discussion? Like not the format, but the question itself that was brought up. That is a point that was raised by several groups. And another question that I actually heard pretty often was uncertainty about the consequences of a decision in there. Like, what would that actually mean? Who of sanity would, in a discussion like that, then say they're on board then anymore or not on board anymore if we actually point into a certain direction? So a lot of people also had opinion about I want this and this, but if that then results in the whole camp not happening anymore, I would potentially have a softer opinion on that. That was also something I heard several times.
And I think one of the things that in almost every group, one of the things that came up in almost every group was, it depends. It depends on the person, it depends on his or her role in the government, and it depends on his or her role in the organ. And that is not actually a conclusion, but it's maybe something we can work on.
Okay. Over.
The groups that I've seen, they said, one group said not too many, only content might be influenced, but they also see that with vendors, that they might be influenced by vendors, and they see that as a risk. The other group said that the question was very broad, and that they came to a consensus about they do not want anyone from the prosecuting authority like actively arresting hackers and such in any part of the order. So volunteership is fine, you can come to the event, you can be on stage if you do a CFP. You cannot be part in the orga because they're afraid of the core orga, like this group, that the event will be disturbed or there will be certain mistakes and they're not trusting that.
Okay, thank you. Round two. Well, round three basically, but for your part, round two.
Round N plus one.
Oh, okay. Same format, this time by letter instead of by number. You know a lot more than you did 20 minutes ago. Well, at least some of you know a lot more, and some of you have at least put your own thoughts in order and the group consensus in order. And the group consensus is what matters right now. Knowing what we know now, knowing what the group feels. I'd like to set up a set of rules, guidelines, bounds, morals. I'm not sure how to formulate it correctly, but I think you. That's why I'm making this a bit broader. Have a thought about what needs to. Our rule book. Where do we draw a line? Where do we draw the gray area? What are if and thens? Don't forget the semicolon after the. Or the curly braces. Sorry, making a joke, that's not appropriate at the moment. That's my mind goes ping-pong. It's difficult to keep a straight discussion. So think about, first off, for yourself, and then as a group, what do we need as an organization regarding government employees as part of our organization, government influence? Think about content, think about finance, think about rules and permits. Try and refrain from discuss topics that are impossible to discuss, stuff that is in our permit. We won't be able to discuss that. That's just go or no go for our event. If you don't want any police officer on the field, I'm making an example, I'm not making a statement. Just being careful here. And the government requires us for our event to allow police officers on the field, and that's not really a point of discussion. That's either go or no go for the event. Do you get what I'm trying to?
So you have to try to think what is feasible.
Feasibility, yeah. I even set that on here somewhere.
Something. Can we just mark whether some opinion is a showstopper or not?
Cool. Yeah. Sure.
So think of a mark. Use that.
Yeah.
If something for you is so incredibly important personally that you're not willing to do this event,
yeah.
If it's a show-stopping thing.
Yeah, just put a little circle around it, say showstopper or whatever. Make a note that we know that it is for you personally or for you as a group, a showstopper. You can, the group consensus, showstoppers in the middle, your personal showstoppers, put them on the outside ring for yourself. Is that enough information to get going again? Yes, sir.
I'm sorry, but I really need to complain about another time.
That's quite all right. That is not a complaint.
Format,
it's an idea.
The exact question that we discussed in phase one in this format will end up strongly influencing the type of rules we are going to set.
Yeah, that's the whole idea. that's a general
I
idea.
I don't like that at all. We are going. The exact question that you ask here in phase one will end up influencing the rules that we are going to come up with in a way that I think many people would not like here.
That is exactly the point of what we're trying to do here. We need to find our lines, and let me finish. We need to find where we, as a group, draw the line. And that may differ, probably, even for me, even for, well, nearly everyone, that will differ from your own personal standpoint. And from that point, you need to think for yourself on, is this the organization I want? Is this a plan I want to follow? That is entirely up to you. That's your own free opinion. But we need to move on as a group, as a consensus is difficult, but oh wow, a lot of questions immediately. Okay, never mind.
I think the conclusion is a bit difficult, considering, well, one side time restraints, the formulation of the question, stating that we're actually creating a line which we try to close, I think might be a bit difficult. As in, this
well,
is
well,
something
we'll have
I don't
to
think we have the possibility to do this in right now.
Let me ask you this. Are you willing to try?
Yes.
Then let's please do that. And if it doesn't work, if it all goes to hell and if we end up screaming at each other, then we know.
That's not what I'm worried about.
No, but just making an extreme statement to point out. Okay, are these quick questions so we can get going?
Yes, I just want to clarify. I keep forgetting people's names, but I think you might be misunderstanding his issue with it. The issue is not that there might be a conclusion that he doesn't like. The issue is that the question is biasing the result and might influence people who don't have a strong opinion into going towards a specific opinion. So you don't.
That was not my intent.
I think that was not my intent. But I do think it's the inevitable consequence of this format.
I think it's the inevitable consequence of any discussion ever.
It's like democracy is the worst option except for all the other options.
Yes.
So we have to do something and we have to move forward now. And if you don't like it, I suggest, Scottly, to get your own discussion. Everyone's free to create their own discussion and create their own camp, but we have to move forward here, and this is what Georga has set about to do, and it's fairly open. It is not perfect, but we have to do something. So,
last question before I get you guys going.
Yeah, so I think most of us are perfectly willing to try this and see what happens, but I think it's for many of us important too that we are also allowed to question the question.
Sure.
Because in my view, the question is at best a very small part of a much broader issue pertaining
that,
to
that is so.
What
that,
the hell is this community about?
Yeah, and that's the problem with discussions. You need to focus. So Stitch and McFly pointed me in the direction for the first discussion, for our first part of our identity, which we need to solve now. There's a lot more that follows on this. This is you cannot have a discussion on all the topics at once. So
that's fair.
So that's why.
As long as we agree that this is not the only question, then
no, that's happy. That we're hackers.
That is already a conclusion. That is not a question. That's already a conclusion.
Okay. So for now, grab a news sheet. Gather your groups sorted by letter, please. Should be around 5-ish people, somewhat less. Someone who hacked 2 tickets might get a bigger group. My letter, please. Let's leave that. Okay. Skip the main screen. I'd like to start with one observation I had during this entire, well, a bit longer than the hour we planned, but hey. Some people requested it. That happens. One thing I noticed was our commitment. The strong way we feel about this event shone through every discussion. Everyone wants this event to happen. Everyone wants to think with the group. Everyone wants to participate. Everyone wants to do their part. So thank you for that. That's really awesome to see in such a large group. That we're here for good reason. For now, I'm turning over the word to projectleiding members here and there. Anyone who wants to go first on their observations? By the way, all the sheets we made, projectleiding will take them with them and have a good read through them and do probably awesome things with them. They will probably promise not to use handwriting recognition, but I'm not guaranteeing anything. So,
I think in almost all groups, concluded that there should at least be some rule about the involvement of people working in government. I didn't see any group who came up with the idea that there shouldn't be any rules.
Have you drilling over there? Microphone.
There you go. So. Yeah? Okay, so all groups came up with there should be a rule, and the groups differ in how the rule should be formulated. And they differ in two respects. One is the people we want to include versus exclude, and for which roles we want to include versus exclude people. Yes.
One group that didn't necessarily need
Okay, I didn't see that group, but sorry. Almost all groups seem to think that excluding the entire government is way too broad. There is no consensus about which part of the government we should actually exclude, whether that should only include prosecuting agencies or all policymakers, or there's difference between everybody, and also on which part of the orga should be excluded. Every group seems to think that everyone should be able to attend the event, so the restrictions should be on. Okay, sorry. But the
Still mentioned on quite a lot of them that yeah. They should be included.
You say almost all, then
okay, sorry. There's difference about what roles should be included versus excluded, whether that should be high risk teams, whatever that may be, whether it should be the core orga or some team wrote down positions of trust in the core orga, whatever that exactly may be, but there's no consensus about that. That is, so maybe there should be a rule, but we don't know what the rule should be.
So yeah, that is the same conclusion. Okay. Die knop daar links indrukken. Anyway, it's broken now. Oh, sorry. All right. So, what Rolf said, yes, exactly that. So there should be a rule. But what Rolf said, there should be a rule. Oh, 30. I have to wait. I have to wait. Yes? Are we back? All right. So, what Rolf said, yes, that's a really nice summary. But it is clear that in most groups, the common ground is that in trust positions, or positions that you should rely on, there cannot be a person from a prosecuting agency, at least. That's something that's shines through most of the conclusions. Some teams also said that you cannot be in such a position if you have a criminal history. So, meaning criminal, like, terrible things. So, I don't know if in the world of activism and criminality, it's a bit vague. But and hacking is a bit fake. Maybe you got arrested for hacking. That's not necessarily what was meant. So the only thing that if we would read through all of these, we wouldn't know if it's phase one or two. So that's very hard. Did you have any?
I think I would see that. I found it also like my observation was also that there is a general agreement that somehow access to for the, and then it becomes unclear if they want to have the core auger, the overall auger, like all of the above, the project lighting and team content was something that was sometimes mentioned. What I see is there is not really an agreement of that what precisely it makes. So, for example, I do lack a C that we all have even with randomly put together groups, we all have an alike idea of what we want. I would have expected that randomly put together groups have a more coherent idea, so that even with those random groups, there is not one idea that comes out of that. And the two discussion things that are in there is basically which group precisely. So does this only love law enforcement or not, or what precisely are allowed to participate in what roles? So for me, the biggest conclusion is we can agree on there should be a somewhat rule, but we can't agree on what the rule is precisely.
So the discussion was also somewhat broadened, like not only government, but also companies that would want to be moving in a certain direction because it's their best interest. Like there's a lot of trust in this organization, in everybody here, even though many people I've never seen, or I've seen but I've never spoken to maybe. I blindly trust those people. I don't know what their background is, and till this day there was no stupid thing that would make me suspicious of any government involvement currently, except for our beautiful fuck up with not introducing someone. I think that's one of the triggers of this whole discussion. And of course, last year we had like two big discussions on the Orga list in the same area, the same thing. So we have to come to some kind of conclusion, and well, that's hard.
I think so far tonight, have a walk around, have a look around, and
yeah.
See what other people wrote, see what they think. There's no time to go through every single stage.
Why is there no time to have 3 minutes of...
Because we have to organize a conference.
We're already at least three quarters of an hour past our scheduled point, so
I'm
sorry about that.
Can I make one comment?
Yeah.
No, I think you're taking not enough time to analyze what's here.
That's
walking around and looking at this. You're already drawing conclusions about if you can and or cannot make a consensus out of this. I think this should be studied more.
I agree.
Again.
Here.
Yeah, there was somebody that respect me. So
I didn't do the respect me.
Sit down, write down the key points from everybody, condense it down.
Everything that we have here right now will be like photographed, will be available publicly.
I think the point is that we shouldn't draw conclusions yet.
Well,
emphasis on yet. You can gain some time in the schedule, skipping the conclusions, which are just not there yet. Just stop drawing conclusions and go move on.
Oh yeah, we can move and do it at the next meeting. We can have this, like, if there are some consensus, like the biggest things we see, the biggest conclusions. So I also made a nice remark, like somebody is angry, I think, on the IRC. Like I said, the line between activism and criminality is a bit vague. Well, depends on where you stand. If you're like a police person, you would see it as criminal. If you would be an activist, you would see it as the right thing to do. So, well, that's their entire the battle that will last forever. So, that's why, yeah, that's not the discussion here. So.
And within this community, I think we all know, we can all distinguish between criminality and activism.
I disagree.
Okay, well, we cannot go into that
sorry, cannot go into that further. So everything will be available. I would like to ask to refrain from discussing endlessly on the mailing list, because that costs us an enormous amount of time. So of course, I don't want to silence you, but that's going against organizing the event. That costs the most time. Like everything that ever happened, this is more costly than that. So at the next event, we will have another run through of everything we have. I think that's the best way to that. And then we can have quick discussions and reactions and such.
Can I give a small suggestion for proceedings? If anyone is unhappy about what's happening, what I said earlier, just come together with people that are like-minded and give a suggestion, just an open letter to the organization, so you can take that into account. And preferably with that letter, say how many people you've
talked with.
Can you repeat them? So if you're not happy with this, come with a counter-proposal outside of these meetings. Don't complain, fix it.
The point was that if you're not happy with the way how we did it, was come up with a counter-proposal of fixing it. That was.
From this comes a sort of middle ground, and there will always be people that agree less or agree more. But you have to.
At a certain point, you have to accept. Like, this is what it is, and we're organizing a conference here, and there will be a lot of things on stage which you agree on. But at a certain point, you have to like.
This is just what it is. Like there will be a lot of content on the stages that you might agree with, that you might not agree with. But we are organizing a conference here. So we are talking about tents, and we are talking about planning and everything that's on the wall, on the outside, and maps, and all what the teams are doing. So this is important, and there are some conclusions that we can draw from everything we've done. The focus should be on organizing, like the discussions and all the really heavy stuff that's maybe even heavier that we ever discussed here would be on the stages in the end. So you're rolling here, you're rolling with the content team. They're doing a fine job. They're like with 14 people already, and they have heavy discussions. So that's interesting. That's what I hear. That's it. And if you don't like that content, then that's the bottom line.
For me, one of the really, really important points is that we get to a point that we start organizing the conference and stop about talking this point. We have a lot of other points that will pop up that are highly controversial. I think we do have a problem sometimes on agreeing things because we're also nerds. We also like to discuss. I think that's true for at least half of the people. And also, I think it is only a subgroup of people that are sitting here. There's already like some people who are not coming intentionally because of this. But I really, for me as a co-organizer, the thing that is important is that I need to have a way of working for soon. So because that means if there might be a conclusion that we come to, then one or two person of the co-orga has to possibly leave. That would be especially like naming the gray elephant in the room. Jorun is from the NCSC, and he's in the co-orga. And if we come up with certain rules that might result in Jorun having to leave or wanting to leave after that, that would get me down to the point that I would have to find somebody again who is active, who can take over. I have to go through all of the discussions we had with the new person, because that happens when you get new people in the room. They basically attack us. They question every discussion that has and every result that this has come out so far in Sanity that has happened. So for me, that actually would be a point. And for me, actually, if that comes again, that we are kicking out people, I actually would have to also think that it's not completely the procedure of how far I see that. Because if we come up with a conclusion that an orga as a greater orga, isn't able to find a rule how to work in and changes the rules and kicks out people of that organization, that it would actually becoming a problem for me. Okay. So I think it would be nice if we come to up with something that is acceptable for me to work in. Meta discussion. And I think one of the conclusions, if you look on the first pieces already is this already the right discussion, which is especially interested because last year the point was Fox IT, which is not government. So I need to have something that I can work with. Like, I don't even want, like, I really don't want to decide that. I really don't. But I just want to have a way of working that allows me and all the other people involved to actually organize a conference. Because that is actually the important thing that we're here for.
Okay.
And I would like to go on with that at some point.
Yeah.
Just one second for me.
Okay. Oh, dear. Oh, this, yeah, I'll try. I really hate microphones. Sorry. From me, a big thank you for all your participation, all your involvement in this discussion, how you handled yourself. If you have any feedback regarding the format, not the actual rules or guidelines or whatever, because that's not me. I'm just part of Orga, not a part of project leading. So if you have any good points, the plus or the delta, the things you want to change and how you want to change them, please give them to me. I'll put them to good use for my lessons and, if needed, possible further discussion. So thank you for your hard work today.